Jessica is with us in Tennessee. Hi, Jessica. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Better than I deserve. What's up?
I had a question. I feel like I'm sitting pretty comfortably, and I'm looking at the point where I want to invest some of my savings for a good future for myself and my fiance. And I guess I needed, or was hoping to get your input on what you think I should do. I have a traditional IRA in place, but I was actually thinking about converting it to a Roth IRA, and I was hoping to get your help from that point on.
Okay, cool. Do you have any debt?
I don't.
Good.
Well, I have my house.
Okay, good. And that, how much do you have in savings for emergencies?
About
$38,000?
Yes.
Okay. And what would 3 to 6 months of expenses be? Is that too much or is that about right? That sounds high. What's your monthly expenses for you to exist? You're not married yet. What's your monthly expenses for you to exist?
Close to right under $4,000, I would say.
A month. Okay, so three months would be 12, 6 months would be 24. Okay, so let's call it 20, and that means you got 18,000 to do something else with. When are you getting married?
In October of this year.
Good for you.
Hopefully, if Good Corona doesn't mess it up.
I hear you. Does your fiance have any debt?
He does.
How much?
He's probably got close to about 15-ish, but we are working on it.
Good. He is working on it. You should not be paying his bills.
Yes, he is working on it.
After you're married, we work on it. But until we're married, he works on it. So first thing I would do is make sure you've got some money set back to pay off whatever debt after the wedding that he has remaining.
Okay.
And so let's say he's going to pay his 15 down to 10. You've got 18 to work with. So we're going to set 10 aside for after the wedding to be debt-free. Then you would be debt-free with an emergency fund as a couple. After the wedding, after October. So that would be my first investment, in quotes, air quotes, that I would do. And then beyond that, we've still got another $8,000 in our little equation we're doing here. I'm just making this up, but this is how I would do it.
Sure.
Then you start putting money towards either a house down payment. You already own a home. Are you guys going to live in your home?
Yes, we are.
Okay, that's solved then. And so now we're talking about the Roth IRA. How much is in your current traditional IRA?
14.
Okay. If you convert that to a Roth, it is all taxable. What is your income?
About 60.
Okay. All right. And so you're probably going to have about 15% of that out in taxes if you convert it to a Roth. And so $3,000 or $4,000 is what that's going to cost you in taxes to go ahead and convert it to a Roth now. That's not a bad use of some of that $8,000. And then you could actually do another Roth IRA for this coming year, this calendar year, of $6,000. And and just put that all in good growth stock mutual funds. And you can click SmartVestor at DaveRamsey.com. It'll drop down a list of the SmartVestor pros in your area that we recommend. We're not in the investment business, but they'll be able to help you facilitate all that. So I think you'd have enough to do a Roth, pay off your fiance's $10,000. He pays it down to five between now and October, and you'd have enough to convert the other thing to a Roth and pay the taxes. You want to set the tax money aside. Don't let that sneak up on you next April. I want to go ahead and have that money sitting there to pay the bill, and that's with a $20,000 emergency fund. And that's how we've got it all laid out. You've done a really good job. All we're doing is fine-tuning your already wise